Hello student, good morning. Today we are going to learn the induced EMF in stationary coil in changing magnetic field by Faraday's law. We have our Faraday's experiment. We have already learned about the induced EMF. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss about the induced EMF in this coil where a coil is stationary and a magnet is moving towards the coil. By the Faraday's law, E is equal to d phi by dt. It means change in magnetic flux with respect to time. That is EMF, induced EMF is directly proportional to rate of change of magnetic flux. By using this law, we will discuss about the EMF induced in a stationary coil in a changing magnetic field. For this, figure A shows that the magnet, this is the magnet coil system. Here, permanent bar magnet is attached to a semicircle frame of a radius 50 cm. This is a semicircle frame of aluminium and the magnet is attached to this frame. The radius of this frame is 50 cm and this frame is fixed at the center. And a coil is used here such as this magnet can through the coil. Whole system is hanged at the center of this semicircle in such way that this magnet can move through this coil. Magnet can move through this coil and this magnet is stationary. The magnet is stationary. Now, when this magnet moves towards the coil, then magnetic flux passing through this coil changes and EMF induces in this coil. When this magnet is at the middle position of this arc, magnet is at middle position of this arc, then the magnetic flux passing through this coil are very few. When this magnet moves toward this coil, then magnetic flux increases with time. It increases slowly with time. When this magnet is near to this coil, then magnetic flux increases fastly and therefore EMF induces in the coil will be maximum. And when this magnet moves through this coil, the magnetic flux at maximum, magnetic flux passes through this magnet, but the change in magnetic flux, is equal to zero. That is, the constant magnetic flux passes through this coil when this coil is inside this, that is inside the coil, then magnetic flux passing through this magnet are maximum, but change in magnetic flux is equal to zero because constant magnetic flux passes through this coil at every position, whenever this magnet is at inside the coil. And when this magnet go at this side or right side of this coil, the magnetic flux again decreases slowly with respect to time. That is, when magnet move at this side, then magnetic flux decreases and there is a change in magnetic flux, large change in magnetic flux. Now we can say that this coil has near about 10,000 turns and the diameter of this coil is as such as this magnet can pass through this coil. यात क्या है? सेमीसर्कल आ है, सेमीसर्कल एल्युमिनियम की फ्रेम आ है, रिजिड फ्रेम ऑफ एल्युमिनियम एंड इस सस्पेंडेड एट द सेंटर, ये जो कॉइल आ है कि सेंटर ला सस्पेंड के लिए आ है, और मैग्नेट इज एट द मिडल पोजीशन ऑफ दिस फ्रेम, मैग्नेट मिडल पोजीशन ला है, अनि यात क्या नहीं कि कॉइल कनेक्ट के लिए आए, क्या कॉइल ला 10,000 टर्न्स आए, the number of turns are 10,000 and the position of coil and magnet are in such way that this coil is at constant position or it is stationary, this coil stationary आए, magnet can move through this coil. या कॉइलचा डायमीटर अशा पद्धतीने बनवलेला आहे जेणेकरून की हा मॅग्नेट त्या कॉइल मधून मूव्ह होऊ शकेल. जसजसा हा मॅग्नेट कॉइल कडे जातो तसतसा मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स हे इंक्रीज होत जातात. फेन मॅग्नेट इज अवे फ्रॉम दिस कॉइल, कॉइल पासून ज्यावेळेस मॅग्नेट लांब असतो त्यावेळेस मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स जे असतात त्या कॉइल मधून पास होणारे ते कमी राहतात ड्यू टू द लार्ज डिस्टन्स इन बिटवीन दिस टू मॅग्नेट अँड कॉइल. जसजसा मॅग्नेट कॉइल कडे जाईल मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स इन्क्रीज होत जातात आणि चेंज इन मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स ऑल्सो इन्क्रीजेस. मॅग्नेट ज्यावेळेस कॉइलच्या मधून पास होत असतो, पासेस थ्रू द कॉइल इनसाइड द कॉइल, दे त्यावेळेला मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स जे असतात ते कसे असतात? कॉन्स्टंट असतात. मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स आर मॅक्सिमम बट कॉन्स्टंट and therefore change in magnetic flux will be equal to zero. But कारण प्रत्येक पॉइंटला ऍट एनी मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स जे असतात ते कसे असतात? सेम असतात. त्यामुळे चेंज इन मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स जे आहे ते काय होतील? झिरो येईल. आणि जसजसा या ठिकाणी हा मॅग्नेट कॉइलच्या या साईडला मूव्ह होतो, राईट साईडला मूव्ह होतो, तसा मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स जे आहे ते काय होतात? कमी कमी होत जातात. जसं जसं हा इकडच्या पोझिशनला येईल तसं मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स हे कमी कमी होत जातात. दिस थीटा इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ मॅग्नेट फ्रॉम द कॉइल. द अँगल थीटा इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ मॅग्नेट फ्रॉम द कॉइल. नाउ दिस कॉइल इज कनेक्टेड to the diode and capacitor, milliammeter and voltmeter also connected to this coil and T is connected, R is the resistance of this coil. By using the ammeter or milliammeter we can observe the current in the coil and the capacitor is used to store energy and this voltmeter indicates the EMF induced in this coil. By using the voltmeter we can observe the EMF induced in the coil. This milliammeter is connected in series. The capacitor and diode are connected as like like this, and voltmeter is always connected parallel. Therefore, this voltmeter is parallel to this coil, that we can measure the EMF along this coil or potential difference across this coil. We can measure the potential difference across this coil by using this voltmeter, so that this voltmeter is always connected in parallel to the coil. And we can measure the current, which is in milliampere. The current which is induced is in milliampere, and this current can be measured by using the milliampere. Key is used here to on off the circuit, and is the internal resistance of this coil. And this circuit is known as the RC circuit, because we use the resistance and capacitor here, and this circuit is the LRC circuit. Now, to measure the inducer EMF, the capacitor and diode are connected across the coil. This inducer EMF here, inducer EMF used to charge the capacitor. C is the capacitance of this capacitor. Induced EMF in this coil is used to charge the capacitor. And when this magnet moves through the coil, then EMF induces in the coil. As at every time when this magnet swings through this coil, but for only one swing, this capacitor will not charge. एका स्विंग मध्ये हा कॅपॅसिटर जो आहे तो चार्ज होणार नाहीये. देअर मस्ट बी नंबर ऑफ स्विंग टू चार्ज कंप्लीटली द कॅपॅसिटर. नंबर ऑफ या ठिकाणी फ्यू स्विंग व्हावे लागतील, त्यावेळेस या ठिकाणी हा जो कॅपॅसिटर आहे तो चार्ज होईल. हा कॅपॅसिटर या ठिकाणी ह्या कॉइलला ह्या सर्किटमध्ये दाखवल्याप्रमाणे कनेक्ट केलेला असतो. कॅपॅसिटर, मिलीमीटर, व्होल्टमीटर, डायोड, की connected to this coil as shown in this figure. And this is the measurement of induced EMF. जो काही या ठिकाणी EMF develop होतो, induce होतो, तो EMF या ठिकाणी ह्या कॅपॅसिटरला चार्ज करण्यासाठी यूज केला जातो. But in one swing this capacitor cannot be fully charged. There must be few swings to charge this capacitor. Now, the capacitor may not get charged up to a peak value in a single swing. This may take a few oscillations to charge the capacitor to a peak value. And when this capacitor will be fully charged, this can be observed by the milliammeter. Then milliammeter shows the deflection in when current flows through milliammeter. Now we know that the EMF induced in the coil E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Minus d phi by dt. This change in magnetic flux will be negative. That is, when the magnetic flux through the coil changes from small value and increases to maximum value, and then we can say fail the magnetic flux or increases, then changing magnetic flux will be the negative value, because the maximum magnetic flux when magnet is near to the position of coil, minus magnetic flux when this magnet is away from the coil, the value will become a negative. Therefore, change in magnetic flux will be, the value of d phi by dt will be negative when the magnet moves towards the coil. And when this magnet moves away from the coil, then the change in magnetic flux, that is the whole term EMF, will be positive. Here in this case, when magnet moves towards the coil, the EMF is positive. And when the magnet move away from the coil, then EMF will be the negative. The variation of magnetic field can be shown by the figure. We can draw a graph for variation of magnetic flux. Now we can draw here the variation of magnetic flux or magnetic field along the x-axis. We can take a time, and along y-axis here we will take the flux. As the magnet is away from the coil, time goes when magnet moves towards the coil, but there is no large change in magnetic flux. Therefore, we can write a graph as this type, very small change in magnetic flux in this case. We will get a curve as this type. This graph we can give the name A, B, C, D, E, and F. Here we can show time between T1 and T2. In between this time, there is a large change in magnetic flux. Therefore, this time at this point C and D is shown T1 and T2. Here is a magnetic flux and the y-axis, or also we can say the magnetic field or magnetic flux. From this figure, we can say that the center of B, C, D, E on this graph, or center of this B, C, D, E, in the position when magnet is away from this coil, we get the graph AB. That is, there is no variation, large variation in magnetic flux. Few magnetic flux passes through the coil, therefore changing magnetic flux will also the constant. But when the magnet is near to this coil, there is a large variation in changing magnetic flux. Here is a time, changing time is small, but changing magnetic flux is large. In this graph, the part CD is constant. The magnetic flux passing through the coil are constant. Magnetic flux passing through the coil are constant. It means that at this position, the magnet is inside this coil. The magnet is inside this coil. Therefore, when magnet is inside this coil, the magnetic flux passing through the coil are constant. And therefore, when we take a magnetic flux, change in magnetic flux, that is d phi by dt. Change at any point in between any two points, when we take the change in magnetic flux with respect to time, there will be the change in magnetic flux d phi will be equal to 0, because this is a constant graph and which is parallel to x-axis here, that is the magnetic flux are constant and therefore change in magnetic flux is equal to 0 for the graph CD. And when the magnet move away from the coil, magnetic flux decreases. We can observe this by this graph. The magnetic flux are going and decreases from point D to D. And when the magnet is very away from this coil, that is we can say at this position, then there are very few magnetic flux which are passes through the coil, and therefore the graph of magnetic flux can be observed, which means this graph EF shows that the magnetic flux are very few, magnetic flux passes through the coil and the flux are very decreasing and very few flux passes through the magnetic. In this graph we do see the magnetic flux are increases rapidly in very small time. In graph CD, in portion of graph CD, the magnetic flux are constant. Therefore, change in magnetic flux with respect to time will be 0. And in this case, the change in magnetic flux are maximum. In this portion, also change in magnetic flux are maximum. And when it means value of d phi by dt will be maximum in this case, and value of d phi dt will be also maximum in this case. But in this case, when we take the E is equal to minus d phi by dt, the change in magnetic flux means magnetic flux at this position and magnetic flux at this position, when we take the subtraction in between these two points, then the upper value minus lower value, this will be positive, d phi by dt will be positive, therefore whole term by equation this will be negative, therefore EMF E will be negative in this portion. And when we take the change in magnetic flux only d phi by dt, the magnetic flux at this point are few, are low, and at this point magnetic flux are maximum. Therefore, the value of change in magnetic flux will be negative, and this negative from this equation, negative, it becomes positive. Therefore, EMF in this portion we will get a positive, and therefore by this graph we can say this graph is related to variation of B. This figure C is related to variation of B, or we can say the variation of magnetic flux with respect to time. Variation of V with time. By using this graph, we can draw a sinusoidal graph of E. we can draw a graph in between EMF induced in the coil and the time, that is T. Now, at initial position in this graph AB, it is the change in magnetic flux are not so maximum, therefore you can draw this graph. We get a value of EMF in positive as well as in negative, therefore we must take axis positive as well as negative axis. This is x axis, this is the y axis, this is minus y, this is a plus y, and therefore we can draw here a graph in between EMF induced in the coil and the time graph. We will get as like this graph. Initially, we get the negative value of EMF in the portion BC. The portion AB is shown here, and the portion BC where we get the maximum negative value of EMF. Therefore, this value we can say the peak value of EMF, and it can be denoted by the E naught. This is the maximum value of EMF. And another portion, that is CD, which is constant, that is change in magnetic flux are zero. Therefore, this graph will show as like this zero. And then again, when we get the maximum magnetic flux, the value of EMF is positive in this case, in this graph, and therefore we can draw a value of EMF in the positive region. Therefore, we can draw as like this. And this value is known as the peak value of EMF. This is the peak value of EMF. And this value is positive value of EMF. Therefore, we can write here positive E, and this is the negative E. Now, maximum value of EMF or maximum positive value of EMF, and this is the maximum negative value of EMF. This, at this time, the time is T1, therefore we can write here T1 and we can write here T. At time T1 and T2, we get the maximum EMF as shown in this figure. And we can say this is the variation of E with respect to time. The figure D, this is the variation of E with time. Variation of E with time. These are two graphs which are obtained from the motion of magnet through the stationary coil. This is the variation of magnetic field, and also we can say the variation of flux with respect to time. And this graph, from this graph we have drawn the graph, that is EMF are taken along this y axis and the time is taken along the x axis. Variation of in time. Consider the effect of these pulses on the charging circuit. The diode will conduct only during the positive pulse, and at first half swing the capacitor will charge up to a we can say the E1 during the next upswing, the diode will cut off until positive pulse is produced and the capacitor will charge up to slightly higher potential. We can say the E2. This will continue for few oscillation till capacitor charges up to a peak value. This can continue up to when capacitor has a peak value of EMF. This positive EMF of peak value of capacitor, and this is the negative EMF, a peak value of EMF. At this stage, ammeter will show no kick in the current of circuit. In order to estimate the E0, the equation induced EMF, that is, we know that E is equal to, or we can say magnitude E is equal to d phi by dt. When we take the value in magnitude, there is no necessary to take negative sign and positive sign. Therefore, this can be written, this equation can be written as d phi by dt. D phi by dt, this equation can be written as d phi by d theta. We know that theta is the displacement of magnet from the coil. Displacement of magnet from the coil. Therefore, changing position of the magnet, it is indicated by the d phi, d theta. This is the d phi, which is changing magnetic flux, and d theta is the changing position or displacement of the magnet. And this equation will be equal to, we taken here d theta, therefore we can take here again d theta divided by dt. From this equation we can say that there is no change in this equation, only we have multiplied by d theta and divided by the d theta to this equation. Therefore there is no change. Therefore we can write d phi by dt is equal to d phi by d theta into d theta by dt. Now, at theta is equal to 0, the mean position, at the mean position, the theta is equal to 0. We know that when magnetic is away from the coil, or when it is near to the coil, there is a large change in magnetic flux. The first term depends on the geometry of the magnet and the coil. At theta is equal to 0, it means at the mean position we have maximum magnetic flux, but instead, but here the change in magnetic flux d phi by dt is 0 at the when magnet is inside the coil. In first term, d phi by d theta, here theta will be 0 at mean position. If theta is equal to 0 at mean position, then the term d phi by d theta will also be 0. Now we will discuss about the term, second term, that is d theta by dt, and this can be deduced from the equation of oscillation. In oscillation chapter, That is, along the y-axis we know that y is equal to a sine 2 pi lt. By using this equation, y is equal to a sine 2 pi lt. We know already this equation, that's this equation of oscillation. The displacement of particle is equal to a sine 2 pi lt, where a is the amplitude, maximum amplitude, then n is the frequency and t is the time and y is the displacement. We can use this equation for the displacement of matter. Therefore, by using this equation, we can find out theta is the maximum displacement of particle, or theta is the displacement of a particle, and here theta naught is the amplitude, that is maximum displacement. Theta naught is the maximum displacement, therefore we can write here theta naught sine 2 pi. Here we will take a mu instead of n into t. In this equation, theta is the displacement of magnet. Theta naught is the maximum amplitude of the magnet, or we can say the maximum displacement of the magnet. Then mu is the frequency of oscillation and t is the time. Now for this equation, we can say that the frequency not is equal to, we know the frequency is reciprocal of time period, that is time period. That is, we can say the frequency is equal to 1 upon t. Put the value of frequency in this equation, then we will get theta is equal to theta naught sine 2 pi by t into t. Now we get the theta is equal to theta naught sine 2 pi by t into t, where t is the time period of oscillation. Capital T is the time period of oscillation, that is, we can say the time period of magnet to complete a one oscillation from its original position. Now we can write here the d theta by dt. D theta by dt, that is, take a derivative on both sides of this equation, then d theta by dt is will be equal to, this term will be remains unchanged or constant because of amplitude of oscillation is constant. Therefore theta naught, the derivation of sine is cos of 2 pi by t into t, and then again the derivation of 2 pi by t into t is equal to 2 pi by t. Therefore we get the equation d theta by dt is equal to theta naught cos 2 pi by t into t into 2 pi by t. We can take a bracket for this. Therefore we can write this equation as 2 pi theta naught upon t into cos of 2 pi by t. This d theta by dt will equal to, this term is taken here, that is 2 pi theta naught upon t into cos of 2 pi by t. That is, change in magnetic flux, that is EMF induced in the coil, or change in magnetic flux, or d phi by d down upon t into cos of 2 pi by t. The peak voltage E naught in the inducer EMF pulse corresponds to d phi by dt. Therefore, we can say that d phi by d theta maximum d phi by d theta occurs at the position near the mean position. Therefore, we can write here E naught is equal to d phi by dt maximum E value of E, that is E naught, will get when there is a maximum change in magnetic flux. Maximum change in magnetic flux, and this is approximately equal to, we can say here, this is approximately equal to d theta by dt into 2 pi by t. The maximum value of EMF E is equal to d phi, maximum change in magnetic flux with respect to time, and this is approximately equal to d phi by dt into 2 pi theta into t. From this equation, we get this equation, and therefore, this is the maximum EMF induced in the coil, where coil is stationary. And from this equation, we can say the maximum EMF induced in the coil is equal to maximum change in magnetic flux with time. And this equation will be approximately equal to d phi by d theta, and therefore d phi by d theta.